developing story. The federal government shutdown is now in its 26th day. That, as politicians bicker over funding the border wall the president wants. 800,000 federal workers are not getting paid, and that includes more than 13,000 here in CBS 46's Glenn Marshall joins us live with details on Metro Atlanta churches. They're now advocating for those affected, Glenn.
Yeah, and when you think about this, the struggle is definitely real for those affected by this partial government shutdown. But two Decatur churches are making miracles happen by blessing their employees, well, their members that are employees with the federal government, with hundreds of dollars.
Ain't counting on Trump for nothing.
The longest shutdown in U.S. history continues, but two Decatur churches are making sure federal employees have some money in their pockets.
I ain't waiting on the Democrats or the Republicans.
Pastor Jamal Bryan at New Birth Missionary Baptist Church gave close to 30 federal employees $300 each.
At some point, you got to do more than pray, because they're trying to take care of their families. And I challenged the church, let's put something in their hands. And the church overwhelmingly responded.
And just a couple of miles away, inside House of Hope Atlanta, Dr. E. Dewey Smith was also in the blessing business, raising $500 from more than 20 federal employees and giving gift cards from local grocery stores. But the miracles didn't stop there.
We also were blessed to have someone to pay the electric bill for every person who's been affected by the furlough. It didn't matter what the past balance was, so everybody who had a Georgia Power bill, an electric bill, that bill was paid in full.
With President Trump saying the shutdown could continue longer, these pastors say it's necessary to be Christ-like when the community is in need.
This is the hour for the church, that not just New Birth, but churches and mosques and places of faith need to be open.
It's one thing to tell people that Jesus is bread in the starving land. It's another thing to take two fish and five butter loaves and provide it to them.
And both churches are working towards being able to feed families affected by this government shutdown at least once a week. For now, we're live here in Decatur. I'm Glenn Marshall, CBS 46 News.